question. I'd like to show some case study of MOL these smart shipping project. Yes. Firstly, today's theme is digital twin. So I'd like to talk about some simple image of digital twin in MOL. This is digital and this is real. So we MOL, operating the vessel based on ship's crew's decision making. We are operating this vessel. But in this sense, now we are sending more and more data to shore site. So we utilize so this digital analysis cycle. We monitor these data firstly and analyze these data. We, MOL, in our office, many staff who experienced captain, chief engineer, working with our ship operation staff and ship technical staff. So, firstly, now we monitoring these data, especially if who has such a marine technical skill, and analyze, and they have awareness or some hypothesis, and then feedback to simulation. The theme is various safety, eco, cargo, or new R&D project. But our step is firstly, we review these data by monitoring data and then feedback to simulation. And then these simulation has some suggestion to ship's crew and then crew decision making again and cycle to actual operation. In the future, it may come in for unmanned vessel, but at this moment, we have manned vessel with experienced seaman. But these digital cycle helps these crew decision making. This is what now we are doing on this project. This presentation, I'd like to mention about each step for this shipping project, digitalization project. First step is visualize what happened on board. So this shows obtain data, how to get the data, and how to visualize, how to monitor. And then if after we visualize what happened on board, and then we can start simulation and support decision making like a digital twin. So for each step, I'd like to mention. First step is obtain the data. MOL activities, I'd like to mention. To get the data, as Imarasat mentioned, we installed all VSAT for all MOL vessels here for smooth ship-shore communication. To enable many projects, we also think these ship-shore communication is the most important key, basic issue. So we install all VSAT for all vessels. And then we now doing the activity for sending various kinds of data. Now we are sending many kinds of data, but the first point is we are sending sensor data, like VDR, data logger, and in case of LNG, like IAS, to show automatically. And in case of MOL, we are collecting 1 minute interval data and sending to shore. In addition, now we are struggling with to develop more another kind of data like non-sensor data, picture, video, and crew health project. We are doing many projects, but later I would like to talk about some of these projects. And in addition, we are now thinking about the digitalized paperwork on board, like e-logbook and e-amount checklist. We are doing some trials. But so far, to obtain the data, we are installing VSAT and the sending the data to shore. And this is a data flow. As Ando-san mentioned, MOL arranged the data collecting unit, which automatically sends VDR data logger set. But our data platform has a compatibility for open platform, NKDL, another platform. So we think another data collecting unit, we have the compatibility. So we can share these data and we can receive these data. We MOL L also thinks this sharing data is very important, and these data to be shared for the best parties to develop many good service. Yes. And then let me talk more about some data platform issue, because this is a key. In case of MOL, as firstly I mentioned, MOL operating various kind of type of vessel, for example, car carrier, bulk carrier, and LNG carrier. So if vessel type, of course, main part, there exists a common sensor, but if a cargo is different, the data set is different. So our data platform, we store standardized data, measure data, like common data, standardized data, and then we also store unstructured data with variety, big data, volume, velocity, variety, especially variety. Yes, of course, in this standardized data, we are collaborating with SSAP project. Yes, and then we are utilizing these data in many patterns. Firstly, we are using a BI tool like Tableau, Python. These data, our staff, during the, normally we can use Tableau more and more. So these standard data, we can simply utilize these data through Tableau. And later on, I'd like to show more detail, but we develop our management system focus. So to focus these standardized data and many variety data coming to here. And in addition, new advanced R&D project. These special projects, these unique data is very important. So to realize this project, we are keeping these variety data in our platform. Next step is visualization for monitor. In this session, I'd like to show about the MOL focus project, how to monitor the data. And AR navigation project, these data, we visualize these data with AR technology. This is MOL Focus web page. We have various kinds of application, and we are now developing application here. But first is Fleet Viewer. This is the monitoring application for onboard what's happening. So I'd like to show some video to using this application. So this fleet viewer is an application for fleet monitoring. So this is a vessel status. Our ship management staff, when come to the office, we see this screen. This shows, for example, the number of alarm on board now activating. And we can set some checklist. For example, scenario base, some checklist, and we are using these status by using this focus. And if needed, we'd like to see more detail. For example, we still have some trouble or something. In such a case, we are seeing very detailed data through this application. Like that way. This application, for example, this is a case of a cylinder oil feed rate. Of course, we see our point is sensor data, cylinder oil, lubricant oil feed rate. But at the same time, to analyze this data, more and more type of information is required. For example, maintenance record. Because the main piston overhaul, cylinder oil feed rate will be increased. So such a maintenance data and these engine type data. If engine type data is different, this standard value is different. So we are seeing this data. And this is the vessel status on scenario base. And we monitor detail in trend graph from shore. This is some case for we used to for this application. First is FO changeover operation for SOX regulation last year. We check for this smooth viscosity control for all vessels using this application and whether vessels are properly following our instruction or not. And now, super slow steaming operation. Now we are, for example, 20%, 30% main engine output ratio. In such a case, we every day suitable operation. But we are checking these suitable vessels operation is properly executed. Yeah, like this way. And the next example case of visualization is our fleet tour application. So I'd like to show about this. This fleet tour. This is the like sharing movie and picture on board. Here. For example, this is the engine room, 360 degree camera information. We can see this picture. Now we are doing a new project with streaming, but this picture, this slide shows 360 picture. But now, due to COVID-19 restriction, we cannot visit the ship so frequently. So in such a time, we see utilize this data, especially for freshman. And other case is not only engine room. During the ship management, we are using this application, for example, the maintenance. Periodically, ship staff and superintendent take a picture and upload here. And we can see, for example, bulk carrier hold condition to plan the dry docking specification. We can compare these hold condition very smoothly, and we develop. Yes. And then so, next is how to visualize data. Next data is onboard, visualize onboard the data. This is onboard case visualization. We provide these AR technology products for all crude oil carrier tanker. This visualization is AIS. Other ship information we visualize in the AR technology. We provide this big screen on board, and the crew can see this AIS information in this screen. This is a calm weather condition, but if for example snow condition, if no good condition, ship's crew cannot see the vessel as a vessel. But this is using the AR technology. It helps identification of ship's crew, even though these severe sea condition. We are using this technology also in nighttime to visualize other information on board by using this screen. Yes, so far I mentioned about the visualized project, but from now on, I'd like to some project about digital twin simulation, next step project. Today, I'd like to show about some voyage routing, voyage optimization, and main engine operation digital twin project. First is the voyage optimization route. This is a case we develop ship performance model on board, and then during the voyage, we run the digital twin project. This is from Long Beach to Tokyo, Japan, but considering the weather information, we run the simulate fuel oil bunker cost and sailing days. And as a result, we are seeking the best scenario, best route on board. Yes, like that way. We're comparing like this. And finally, I'd like to mention talk about some digital twin model for main engine. We are now developing digital twin model of main engine. as a joint research with National Maritime Research Institute, NMRI, and we are sending all the main engine actual data to this digital twin model. Digital twin model, we contribute to realize the following targets. This is our purpose of this project. For example, monitoring engine parameters, optimizing operation, seeking for optimal operating points, and identification of degradation trend to establish CBM. Yes. Now we start this project. So far, sometimes we have a difficulty, but let me mention about this status. We analyzed this 1 year's engine data of VLCC and one example of estimation of scavenging air pressure and exhaust bypass valve model parameter back here. Currently, the pressure estimation is good, but some parameter does not converge to a stable due to lack of proper data and detailed design data. But now we are collaborating with design and to identify the model parameter, we are now developing cluster algorithm. The model is built with respect to the representative data and the center of cluster corresponding to the most frequent engine operation. Now we are doing like this. So now we are struggling with this digital twin project. And as a result, we hope this result can feed back for decision making. This is an image of what happened on board, but now as is, non-experienced ship's crew output quality is lower comparing with experienced crew. But these results of digital twin support all crews, especially non-experienced ship's crew, like that way. And of course, these results affect experienced crew, so averagely, our ship staff quality gets improved. Like that way, we are now struggling with this digital twin project, and now we are doing the best for this project. Yeah, thank you very much. This is the finish of my presentation. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Please stay there, Ashida-san. Can you hear me?
Yeah, hear you.
Great. We do actually have a question for you. The question is, you mentioned VSAT installation on MOL vessels. Yeah. Is this to transmit the big data you mentioned related to focus? Do you need to send all data to shore in real time, or can you do data processing on board the ship and send small files with results to shore?
Yes, thank you very much for the question. And at this moment, we are sending the data basically real time in data. But some project for digital twin and prediction failure diagnosis project, we are edge side, on board side, analyze data and smaller and send to shore. This depends on the project. Yes, thank you very much.